and scripting content on the DMP-7000 with show control system. This video will explain the process of copying content onto the Venus 7000 computer, then creating a button in Display Studio to play that content on the display. Feel free to follow along on screen or on your own DMP-7000 and show control computers as we explore the program. The term content is used to define any visual image that appears on the display. This could be a still image, such as a JPEG picture, or an animated graphic, such as an AVI file. If content has been created using third-party software, it's often copied to the Venus computer using a flash drive or downloaded if your system has access to the internet. These files need to be stored in a specific location in order for Venus to read them. To simplify the process, these folders are often mapped as a drive letter that appears under My Computer on the Show Control desktop. If your system drives are not mapped, they can be found by going to My Computer, Network, select the Venus 7000 primary computer, V7000. Before we begin loading content, let's look at the file structure of Venus 7000. If your Venus computer has a D drive, the V7000 folder will be there. If not, it will be on the C drive. In the V7000 folder is a subfolder for each sign in your system. These folders cannot be moved or renamed, so it's a good idea to become familiar with the sign sizes in your facility. In each sign folder is a default .lib folder. This library folder is where the various pieces of content must be stored. You can create more library folders within the sign folder to organize content, keeping in mind that the folder must include the .lib file extension. Place the content in the library folder by copying it from its source. Now that the content is in a library folder, it can be played on the display by scripting a button in Display Studio. In the Display Studio software, make sure a scripting container is set up by right-clicking in the gray space and selecting New, Scripting Container. Inside the container, right-click in the empty area and select New Button. We will now add the command to the button to play the content to the display in a process called scripting. Click the plus symbol. This will add a new line of script. Notice the 5 steps at the top of the box. These steps will help guide you through the scripting process. In step 1, leave DMP-7000 player control selected. Click on step 2. Choose the sign that you want to play the content to. Then click step 3. Select play. Move on by clicking step 4. Click the add button to browse to the item to be played. The browser will only show the sign folder for the sign selected back in step 2. Move on to step 5. Continuous should already be selected. This will play the file continuously until a different button is clicked. Name the button by highlighting the word play in the top text field and entering a name to describe the button. Finally, click save. When the button is clicked, the script will activate and play the content on the display. This concludes loading and scripting content on the DMP-7000 with Show Control. Continue to the next video for more information.